Are nested for loops the spawn of Satan? Am I going to burn alive and explode when I have to write a program with nested for loops? Well, if you watch this video, you'll be just fine. Hey, it's Alex back again, helping you get working code quicker in your Java programs. On this channel, I make Java tutorials just like this one, so if you're new here, consider subscribing. Let's kick it off as we do here on the channel. We'll do our nested for loops program. Hit finish. Throw a class in here. Like so, and we'll call it nested for loops. Take the public static void main, hit finish, and we're all set up. So let's get into this nested for loops explanation. I did do a video covering regular for loops, so I recommend you watch that one on the screen now before you watch this one. What a regular for loop does is repeat code, and it also has a secret changing variable that changes each time it repeats. So to make a regular for loop, we just type this. For, and we make our variable. Then we say how many times we want it to repeat. We increment it by one, and then we throw our code inside of the curly braces. So we'll go ahead and print like, it's so freaking cold outside. And if we run that, we get it's freaking so freaking cold outside printed 5 times. The secret variable is called I. And it changes each time it's run. This is especially useful for getting elements from an array. So if we had a string array, let's say of colors, like this, and we throw some colors in there, we say red, let's do blue and green. I also have a video on arrays. If you want to watch that video, I'll have it on the card now. If we want to get each of these values from the array, red, blue, and green, we can just throw it inside of a for loop. We'll set it up just like the other one, except we'll go until the end of the array, which is 1, 2, 3. Like that. We'll go up by 1. And what do we want to do? Well, we want to print out each element of colors. So we go into colors. And then get each element. The first time this is run, it will get color 0, since we start at 0. The next time it will get color 1, and then color 2, which corresponds to red, blue, and green. So let's save that and run it so you can see if we get red, blue, and green. Now let's add some little dividers here just to organize some things, space them out. Then we'll get into the meat of it. Yeah, the meat of nested for loops. I've been programming for over 7 years, and I'd say 90% of the time you're gonna be using nested for loops to get elements from a 2D array. If you wanna learn more about 2D arrays, I'll have it in the card now, but we can just make one here and do an example of how to use nested for loops to get all the elements in a 2D array. So it's pretty much exactly like what we did here. So let's first make a 2D array called fancy colors, and we'll have it have some of the same values here. We'll do red, blue, and green on the first row, and then on the second row, now let's make this a little bigger. On the second row, we'll do, let's see, cyan, magenta, and turquoise. Turquoise. Is that how you spell turquoise? If you know how to spell turquoise, leave it in the comments. All statements end in a semicolon, so we'll add that semicolon. To get elements from a 1D array like we did here, is we just got the first one by doing colors 0. We got the second one, and then the third one. To get values of a 2D array, it's the same thing, except we keep track of the rows. So we go to the first row and then get the first, second, and third. And then we go to the second row and get the first, second, and third. So we have to take care of the rows first. So let's make a for loop to take care of the rows. We'll start at row 0. We'll call this row 0 because it's easier for for loops. And then we want to go up until row 2. So we go 0, 1, and then there's no index 2, so it'll stop. We increment it, and this will take care of our rows. It'll do this row, and then this row. But now we need to do the columns of each row. So, we know how to get the columns of each row. That's exactly this, right? Because we get this column, then this column, then this column. So, we pretty much just do this, right? So, let's do that. Int I equals 0, I is less than 3. Just like this. Boom. And there's an underline here because we already used the variable I here. So we have to change it. And most of the time what we'll do is just change it to J. And then if you had another for loop, you'd change it to K and so on. It really doesn't matter. This is just a convention that is widely used and people use it all the time for nested for loops. And a nested for loop is just a for loop in a for loop. Now we'll go through each column. We'll print out the fancy colors. Fancy colors. The I is our row and the J is our columns. So we'll do I, J. And this is probably confusing as hell right now. So I'm just going to change this variable because it's not very clear. We'll say row. So the first for loop is looping through the rows. Row 0, row 1. And the second for loop is taking care of the columns. So we do column instead, like that. So we have column, column, column. And we'll just place it row, column. An easy way to remember the order is that an array starts with a row. So that might help someone out there. Enough of me talking, let's save it, run it, and see what happens. We get red, blue, green, cyan, magenta, turquoise. And that's exactly the order we had in our 2D array. Red, blue, green, cyan, magenta, turquoise. Don't worry too much if you didn't get every single detail about this. We're just gonna do another example because that's how we do it here. We know that nested for, here, let's make this a little better. We know that nested for loops are just a for loop in a for loop, which sounds kind of confusing, but it's not too bad. We'll start at 0 for the first one and maybe go to 5. Just like that. And what do we want to repeat 5 times? Well, we want to repeat another for loop 5 times, like this. And we have to make a new variable since I is already taken. And we'll say we want to repeat this code 10 times. And increment that by 1. To see what's going on, we can print the values I and J. So let's do that. We can do that just like this by using some simple, sort of complicated looking string combinations. So what I'm doing now is printing the value or the string I and then tacking on the actual value of I. And then I'll tack on the value of J separated by a comma to just sort of format it a little nicer. Like this, and then tack on the real value of J. So let's save it, minimize this, and run it and see what those values are. And this really gave me a great idea of what is actually going on when I first started learning how to code. So if we just look at this one more time, so this gets done 10 times with its own variable J, and then this whole thing gets run 5 times with its variables I and J. So it's printed out 50 times. Play around with it, change the numbers, and I think you'll start to get the hang of it over time. It looks confusing. I tried my best to explain it, how I understood it, and hopefully it helps you out. All the code will be in the description, so don't try to memorize any of it. You can copy and paste it from there. Question of the day, what are you using nested for loops in your Java program? Is it for an assignment or a class project? What are you working on? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to see what you're doing. Make sure to subscribe so you see all my newest videos the day they come out. If this was helpful, smash that like button and share it if you think it might help someone you know. You could be anywhere in the world, but you're here with me, and I appreciate it. Catch you.